King Solomon such a great man?
And what kind of a king is this King Solomon?
Absalom and Solomon were King David's favorite sons. But Absalom had repeatedly betrayed his father. Each time he was forgiven, but he never learned to grow wise. Finally, the soldiers of King David were unable to stand idly by. They tried to capture Absalom. Being aware of this, Absalom mounted a horse and escaped into a thick forest. And the soldiers were unable to capture him. But Absalom's long hair became entangled with the branches of a tree. And in the end, Absalom died, hanging from the tree as though he had been executed for his misdeeds. On the other hand, Solomon, his other son, was truly devoted to the Lord and to his father, King David. And he became the one to succeed David in the kingdom. King Solomon is a great man.
The temple will be a rectangle, like this, and its entrance will face the east. The entire structure will be divided into three parts. First, the Urim. In other words, it will be a foyer, the smallest space. And from the Urim, we enter the Hikaru. The Hikaru is the second space, the outer chamber, which is a holy place. It is a rectangle, and there is an altar to offer incense, the altar to place offerings of bread, and a place for 10 candlesticks. From this outer chamber, we enter the inner chamber, the most sacred place, the Debir, the Holy of Holies.
I shall place the Ark of the Covenant in the Debir. And here I shall put the statues of 2 praying angels, the cherubims. This place is God's holy house. And I shall permit only sanctified men to enter.
This is the conceptual drawing of the external appearance of the temple after completion. Just outside of the temple, there will be 2 bronze columns decorated with large cushion capitals. And facing the courtyard, a holy water basin for the priests to cleanse themselves will be placed on the heads of 12 bronze oxen.
Yes, I see. And the altar for the sacrificial offerings?
The altar for sacrificial offerings shall be right here, in front of the space kept for the people. The sacrificial altar will be like a huge mountain, as you can see.
Splendid. The holy temple will be something that will astonish everyone who looks at it. I shall summon all of the best workers from every kingdom of this world.
Exactly 480 years had passed since the sons of Israel had left the land of Egypt. And today, the son of David began to build the temple of the Lord. Solomon mobilized 70,000 stevedores, 80,000 stone cutters to work in the quarries in the mountains. The king of Tyre sent Lebanon cedar fiber, and sandalwood to King Solomon. Gold came from the mines of Parwaim, and precious stones were brought out from
This palace must surely have wealth and power.
For many years now, I have been told by the merchants who have come here from all directions about the greatness and splendor of King Solomon, about his power and wealth, and about his father, the invincible David. Tell me the truth. Is King Solomon truly the man all the merchants claim he is?
I am afraid that if you do not see him with your own eyes, you will never believe it. Solomon, the son of King David, rules over all the tribes and all the countries that spread out from the Euphrates to the border of Egypt and the country of the Philistines. And he passes judgment in his kingdom that the Almighty Lord has blessed and filled with divine grace.
King Solomon, this woman and I are living in the same house. It was there that I gave birth to a baby boy. And 3 days later, this woman also gave birth to a baby boy.
There is no one else residing in the house where you both live?
Sire, there's no one living there but the two of us.
One night, while sleeping, this woman caused her baby to suffocate, and it died. When she realized what she had done, she took my baby while I was asleep and substituted her dead baby in its place.
That is a lie. The one who caused the baby to die while asleep was not me. It was this woman. The baby that is still alive is my baby.
Be still. Behave in front of the king.
It is obvious that one of you is lying. Hand me a sword.
Huh?
Here you are, sir. Pick up the baby. baby is the woman who just cried out, "Do not kill the baby." Solomon replied, "Give me the mind to hear reason and the wisdom and knowledge to rule over people." The Lord was impressed by the young King Solomon's modest attitude and blessed him with wisdom and knowledge. Every Israelite spoke of the king's judgments, and the king inspired them with awe because they were all mindful that God's wisdom and his justice lodged in the king's mind.
I am interested. I wish to meet him. I wish to meet this King Solomon.
Something that cannot be found anywhere else in the world.
What shall I do to hear it at my palace?
This is Miriam, the daughter of Zabdi. I shall offer her to you. This girl shall play the harp for you at your pavilion, and she shall teach your sisters how to play the harp. After that, send her back to us, as her own family will also be waiting for her.
With you, I did not believe the words the merchants said about your town. But what I heard was true. Everything they said was true. Now I can believe every word they say, for I have seen it with my own eyes. Your women are very fortunate. Your retainers are indeed also very fortunate. Bless your God.
If you have anything you wish to ask of me, do not hesitate.
I see that you are still very young. I wish to know if it is possible for you to live as a wise man throughout your life, for as long as you live. For there has never been a country whose reputable king was not corrupted by his own wealth and his own mistresses.
That is continue to be faithful to my God, I know I shall stay a man of virtue.
To stay the way you are now for all of your life will be extremely difficult.
Solomon last saw the face of his father, King David. As Solomon grew older, he stopped caring for his holy Lord. He became victimized by earthly desires, in spite of his wealth and wisdom. Instead of the Lord, he devoted his love to the women of the Moabites, the Ammonites, the Edomites, the Hittites, the Sidonians, and many other foreign women.
Is there something you wish to say?
I assume you know that I am from Sidon, sire.
I do remember.
And I have been serving you for 10 years now, my king. And still, you do not allow me to respect the god that I believe in.
Is your god called Ashtoreth? Never. I will never permit you to burn incense for your god inside the fortress of David.
I am well aware of that, sire. But outside, even outside of the fortress, can I not do that? If you do not permit me to worship my own god, how can I serve you for 10 more years, and for 10 more years after that?
Of the fortress?
I am forever grateful to you, sire. Am I permitted to worship just anywhere outside the fortress?
Pick any place you like.
Thank you. Thank you very much, King Solomon.
Why? Why did you permit her to do such a thing, Father?
Lahav, I know what you want to say, but you heard me. I said outside. Outside of the fortress of Jerusalem. It does not matter if it is outside.
Ashtoreth! Ashtoreth! Oh, God, it's a city!
What is happening here? I wonder if we have really arrived at the town of David. Or could this place be a land of pagans?
I am positive the law of Moses says thou shalt not make any graven images of any kind.
Oh?